Assalamualaikum and good day everyone. Welcome to UMT Massive Open Online Course. I am Aminur Muzalina Mustafa, Senior Lecturer at School of Fisheries and Aquaculture Sciences, University of Malaysia, Terengganu. Today, we will discuss on Part 1, topic entitled Use of Microalgae as Feed in Aquaculture Hatcheries. In this topic, we will focus on biological study of microalgae, application of microalgae in aquaculture hatcheries, and how to cultivate microalgae and preserve it as feed in aquaculture hatcheries. To begin with, I will show you the outline of this topic. The first part is we need to know what is the microalgae, how it reproduces, and what is the main biochemical composition in the microalgae that are important as feed, and what types of organisms that need microalgae as their feeds. In the second part, we will learn on how to isolate, establish, and maintain the starter cultures, and finally, we will discuss on different types of methods to mass cultivate the microalgae in hatcheries and then preserve it as feed. Let's start with definition of microalgae or phytoplankton. The words phytoplankton come from two Greek words, phytos for plants and planktos for wandering. The phytoplankton consists of photosynthetic organisms that are adapted to live and wander in the open surface waters of lakes, rivers and ocean. Cyanobacteria, greens, diatoms, cryptomonas, dinoflagellates, heptophytes and cryptophycian are algae groups especially enriched in planktonic species. The phytoplankton species play many important ecological roles in aquatic ecosystem and affects human affairs in many ways. Planktonic algae are the primary producer of aquatic ecosystem and from the base that support that zooplankton and fish of aquatic food webs. Reproduction in microalgae is primarily asexual. Vegetative reproduction consists of the equal division of the mother cell into two daughter cells, each exactly half the size of mother cells. Thus, the metabolism of microalgae is directed towards cell division and increase in size, using light as the sole energy source. However, under certain conditions, some algae can utilize organic substrate in manner similar to bacteria and fungi. The chemical composition is a key factor contributing to the nutritional value of microalgae. Under standard growth conditions, that is where nutrients are not limited, microalgae typically contain between 25 and 50% of dry weight as protein, 5 to 40% as carbohydrate, 10 to 30% as lipid, and 5 to 40% as ash. The amino acid composition of the protein fraction is very similar between different microalgae and relatively unaffected by light and nutrient condition. The major lipid classes are triacylglycerol and the polar lipids. Lipid class composition depends on microalgae species and growth condition. All microalgae contain sterols either as the free sterol or as a fatty acid ester, glycoside or sulfate. A few microalgae also contain small amount of unusual lipids, such as hydrocarbons and alkenones. Microalgae contain a diverse range of pigments, especially lipid-soluble carotenoids and chlorophyll. Pigments are also important nutritionally as coloring agent and as antioxidants. Of the vitamins, ascorbic acid occurs in highest concentration and show the greatest variation. Other major vitamins which includes beta-carotene, niacin, alpha-tocopherol, thiamine, riboflavin, and vitamin D. The main element within the mineral or ash fraction include phosphate, calcium, sodium, potassium, chlorine, ferrum, magnesium, and silica. Microalgae are exploited as a food source for the commercial production of many aquaculture species. The first microalgae species used in the aquaculture have been selected from those that develop naturally in the freshwater or marine environment of pioneering aquaculture farms and were probably the easiest one to cultivate. The picture in the slide summarizes the 60 genera of microalgae most commonly grown for aquaculture purpose. Within the hatcheries environment, microalgae are directly eaten by all growth stage of bivalve, post-set abalone and larvae stages of some crustacean species, and their very early development stage of some fish species. Microalgae are also used as feed to culture zooplankton, for example, artemia, rotifer and copepods, that are used as food for larvae and juvenile stages of many fish and crustacean species. Now, let's continue our lesson on how to isolate, establish and maintain the starter cultures of the microalgae. Isolation of the species and strain suitable for use in aquaculture is not simple because of the required small cell size, for example, 1 to 10 micrometer, and the association with other epiphytic species. Therefore, it requires relevant knowledge and skill, patience and specific equipment. Several laboratory techniques have been used for isolating individual cells, including separation using micropipettes, serial dilution cultures, successive planting on agar media, and centrifugation techniques. These techniques may be supplemented with use of antibiotics to obtain azonic cultures. More recently, automated technologies like flow cytometry with cell sorting have been applied for isolating small cells, which can then be sorted into multi-well plates for establishing new microalgal cultures. The technique also allows for separation for co-occurrence contaminants, for example, bacteria. Once isolation are established, microalgae are grown and maintained in enriched culture media. The choice of medium is very species dependent and will depend on whether the microalgae comes from freshwater, brackish or a marine environment. Media contain macronutrients such as nitrogen and phosphorus, as well as micronutrients such as iron, zinc, cobalt, cadmium and molybdenum, and vitamins. Stock cultures or master cultures are typically kept in culture tube or small glass flask fitted with the cotton wool or packed cellulose plug at the neck. These are often maintained in specially allocated constant environment rooms or cabinets where temperature and lighting can be strictly controlled to match physiological requirements. Stock cultures are used only to provide inocula for starter cultures when required and are generally subcultured every 2 to 6 weeks by aseptically transferring a small volume to sterile flasks with culture medium. For longer-term storage of microalgae starter cultures, many of the strain may be maintained on algae slopes or plates enriched with nutrient media. Cell suspension may be also cryopreserved by the addition of 10 to 50% dimethyl sulfoside as cryoprotectant and then freezing with and storage in liquid or vapor phase nitrogen. To restore the culture, samples are torn and transferred in fresh media. Now, let me proceed on how to mass cultivate the microalgae in hatcheries. The intensive production of larvae and juvenile animals within hatcheries require a large-scale production of microalgae as live feed. The general process of scale-up involves the successive transfer of actively growing, dense culture, for example, mid-late logarithmic phase, to large volume system containing fertilized seawater or freshwater, at inoculation ratios ranging from 1 to 5 to 1 to 100. Exact protocols and culture endpoints. will vary between hatcheries, but the typical scale-up could be from 20 to 200 male starter cultures to 0.5 to 2 liter flask to 10 to 20 liter carboys to 100 to 1000 liter polyethylene bags or cylinder to tubes, tanks, ponds or raceways of between 1000 and 100,000 liter. Figure in the slide show different types of system has been used to mass cultivate microalgae in the hatcheries, which include closed and open pond system. Cultures may be operated in batch mode, where the entire volume is harvested once cells have achieved sufficient density. Alternatively, in continuous mode, the culture is continuously harvested and media replenished are at a rate to sustain a specific growth rate. In semi-continuous mode, a proportion of the volume, example 20 to 50%, is removed every 2 to 4 days and replaced by fresh media. In the last stage of mass cultivation of microalgae, we need to preserve microalgae as feed. The on-site production of microalgae for immediate use as live feed remains a necessity for most hatcheries because of cost, logistics, and the high nutritional value they can offer as feed during the critical larvae feeding stages. Nevertheless, there have been some significant developments in the off-the-shelf alternative during the last few decades that have seen that their use increase as partial or in some condition total replacement for freshly cultured microalgae. Concentrated preserved microalgae appear the most promising, with many studies demonstrating that they can substitute for fresh microalgae for green water applications and in the culture of rotifers, shrimp larvae, and juvenile mollusks. Moreover, the growth and survival of certain larvae may be even be improved when they are fed algae concentrates compared to equivalent algae cultures. Concentrates are developed by applying specific harvesting techniques to concentrate the microalgae culture, followed by the processing or storage protocol to preserve the microalgae. Various harvesting techniques can be tested, but centrifugation and chemical flocculation are the most suitable for preparing concentrates for aquaculture feeds based on cell density and harvesting efficiency. Other alternatives to living microalgae that has been investigated as hatchery feeds have included formulated microparticulate, microbond and encapsulated diets. We are now come to the end of this topic. As the conclusion, you are now able to identify what types of microalgae and their application in aquaculture hatcheries. Learn on how to isolate, establish and maintain the starter cultures, and finally, know the methods on how to mass cultivate the microalgae in hatcheries and preserve it for long-term usage and storage. Hope you enjoy the video and we continue the next part with Dr. Nadia. Thank you.